Namaskar. Welcome to Vision of Asia, Voice of the Community. I'm Kala Shankar. Let's begin today's show by taking a moment to wish all mothers, grandmothers, and mothers-to-be a very happy Mother's Day. In today's Vision of Asia, in addition to our weekly segment, This Week with Padma Shri Dr. Sudhir Parikh, discussing current issues from Indian politics, we will also have a report on the New York Indian Film Festival, a report on an event organized by the International Ahimsa Foundation at the Indian Consulate in New York, a look at the Dulhan Expo in New Jersey, the 50th anniversary of the Sesame Street show, and a spring cocktail fundraiser by the Share and Care Foundation. Vision of Asia, a very exciting program full of vibrancy and variety from our community on ITV Gold, will continue right after this short break. The New York Indian Film Festival is the oldest and most prestigious film festival, screening premieres of feature, documentary, and short films made from, of, and about the Indian subcontinent in the independent, art house, alternate, and diaspora genres. New Yorkers get the opportunity to immerse themselves in a variety of movies and interact with filmmakers. This film festival opened on May 7th with a film called Sir, and will conclude today, May 12th, with a movie directed by Vikas Khanna titled The Last Color.
अगर आप नहीं है तो मैं बाहर जाके आ सकती हूँ
हाँ
टेलरिंग कोर्स के लिए सामान लेना था
गुड
तो तेरा टेलरिंग का भी है ना
अगर सरांची परमिशन नहीं घेतली अजून ना
टाइमिंग्स क्या है
तू से चल सारे काम खत्म करके जाऊंगा
ठीक है
Thank you, sir.
I would like to congratulate New York Film Festival committee and particularly Sunil Hali, a good friend of mine, who has put together this great show. And we must encourage and support him for bringing the great movies and great producer and actor and supporting the community. And Sunil, congratulations and wish you all the good luck.
Since you have been known to me for 27 years, so we're just following, making sure the legacy you guys have created, that legacy needs to be taken forward and then be given to the next generation.
And all these movies and we'll be going to and interviews with the board of directors and all the happening we are going to show on our ITV throughout the week. And Sunil, let us know. You can always count on us to promote anything what you are doing, any of your initiative.
From all their properties, Desi Talk, News India, ITV and personally and your newsletters have been very big help. You can see it has helped to bring the audience here. Keep it growing. Be the voice of the community, not here, all over the world.
Once you cut a few thousand from the salaries, they're straight.
तुम बचपन से टेलर बनना चाहती थी। मैं तो सिर्फ इतना कह रहा हूँ कि फैशन की दुनिया में आगे बढ़ना बहुत मुश्किल होता है।
मुझ जैसों के लिए
नहीं
आप जो भी फील करें आखिर में मैं आपकी सर्वेंट ही हूं ना
लुक एट थिंग्स फ्रॉम हर पर्सपेक्टिव इफ यू रियली लाइक हर जस्ट लेट हर बी
फक टेल मी हाउ यू फील
सर
प्लीज मुझे सर मत
बोलो। I've come to every year. It's growing every year. More and more fascinating movies, and I'm very thankful for the opportunity to meet all the wonderful people here. Thank you.
I wanted to tell a story of something that I haven't seen and which I wanted to see, and I think this is something that nobody has. Like not many have tried to attempt to tell a story. There's so much more that happens in a 16-year-old girl's mind psychologically. So I wanted to capture that. So that's how this movie.
About my film, it's called Draupadi Unleashed. This film is about a young girl coming of age until she falls in love with yours truly. And how we then elope and how traditions in our Indian culture and how that is put into test because of love. So if anybody wants to check out some really incredibly shot film based in the 1930s, please make it.
Parik, I'm here with my friend Mr. Arora, who has a produced movie called Salute. It's a great movie, it's a great story, it's a true story.
Yeah.
And we are going to showcase it on the Thursday 6:30. Please, everyone should come and support that movie and enjoy the movie. And really, I congratulate you for your great production, great creation, and please keep doing the good work. And congratulations and good luck again. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Sapna Bhavnani. I'm here with my first debut, Sindhustan.
Hi, my name is Kabir. I'm the producer and editor of Sindhustan.
Of the largest migration of a culture in the history of the world, told through ink, tattoos. So the whole story is on my legs, and the whole film is edited with my legs. So please come and watch my legs.
It's a wonderful story because, like, the Sindhi community hasn't got enough representation, and her doing this film in the way she's done it, the form in which she's done it, I think is very interesting, and that's the kind of representation one needs, rather than like a dry film.
And they are really showing the history of how migration happened during the partition, right?
Yes.
And we know the history that a lot of people suffered, a lot of people had left their homes, they left their properties, left everything, and they came here from Pakistan to India, and quite a few people from India to Pakistan. And I'm sure that the movie is very emotional and gripping movie, and I would like to join on that day to see your movie.
My film is Jalebi. It's a short film. I directed the film in New Jersey. The best part of the film is my dad is in the film. The film is about the individuals who are from India and Pakistan living in US, and when something goes bad back in home, how we relate to the situations happening. And despite the fact we all call ourselves Desis, the emotions sometimes overtake us. So I'm not going to tell more than that. If you want to watch the film, I'm looking forward to see you guys. Thank you so much. Keep watching ITV. Thank you.
The International Ahimsa Foundation organized an event with the Consulate General of India, New York, in a series of events to mark the 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi. The theme was Nonviolence, a message of Lord Mahavir. The inaugural address was delivered by the Consul General of India, Sri Sandeep Chakravorty. Congresswoman Carolyn Maloney and Professor Lawrence A. Babb were special guests. Samani Malay Pragyaji and Samani Niti Pragyaji were the guest speakers on this occasion. The president and founder of International Ahimsa Foundation, Dr. Nita Jain, coordinated for this event dedicated to meaningful interactions. Here's a special report by ITV Gold.
You know, it was a beautiful occasion because several things came together. You know, we are celebrating 550th birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev Ji. We are celebrating 150th birth anniversary of Mahatma Gandhi Ji. And also we celebrated here today the 2618th birth anniversary of Lord Mahavira.
So this is a very special year, special occasion, where three apostles of peace, Lord Mahavira, who was born in the 6th century BC, and then then Guru Nanak Dev Ji 550 years back, and Mahatma Gandhi 150 years back. So I think their message is I think one and the same. It's the message of humanism, it's the message of love, it's the message of each reaching out to the other and message of peaceful coexistence. So we may think that the India-US connection is very new and it is because of all of us, but our leaders, I think, knew how to talk to each other even hundreds of years back, and I think that is the strength of our bilateral relationship.
As we all know that Gandhiji was a big follower of Jain principles, which were given by Mahavir Bhagwan almost 2,000 years ago, and his the supreme religion of humanity was nonviolence, which is we need more today than ever, looking at what is happening in all the world, around the world, the violence, the discrimination, all sorts of negative things are going on. So in today's world, we really need to spread the message of Mahavir, of nonviolence. And I urge all of you to please join this foundation, go on website of International Ahimsa Foundation, New York, USA, and join this foundation to spread the message of Mahavir, of nonviolence. Thank you so much for joining us. Presenting this one book, which is the book stand for Jain Dharma, Ahimsa, and Mahatma Gandhi. And this book was written by our other guru, Vidyananji Maharaj, in Delhi. And this also had facts and statements of Mahatma Gandhi in this book, which is also translated in English in each page. So if you want, you can enjoy it.
Thank you. I will cherish this. Thank you so much, my dear friend. We are here to celebrate Lord Mahavir. I never knew that he said, live and let live, but that's one of the most famous quotes in America, live and let live, and of course, Mahatma Gandhi. Gandhi was a truly, truly inspirational leader, a historic figure. He was transformational in so many ways, and because of his many contributions, not only to India, leading India to independence with nonviolence, but also he was an inspiration to all Americans and people all over the world. And two great leaders, nonviolent leaders, Nelson Mandela and Martin Luther King, attributed their philosophy and their leadership to Mahatma Gandhi.
Every year I come here to take part in not only the celebration of this organization, but to spread the message of nonviolence. And of course, this is a very special year because it's now the 150th anniversary of the birth of Mahatma Gandhi. And as we celebrate Lord Mahavir's founding of the Jain religion, this is, I can't tell you how special I feel. This year we've been to many, many commemorations of the 150th birthday of Mahatma Gandhi, and we should continue to do so because this is a man that really has been an inspiration to literally, literally generations of people from around the world. And of course, Lord Mahavir being the founder of this incredible religion that I am not new to, because Dr. Nita Jain has been indoctrinating me with this religion for the last two decades.
The Indian American community, in my opinion, never forgets the civic and civic participation in government and local community. You do it for the Indian community and you do it for New York in general. And I want to congratulate you on that, because it's not every community that does that kind of understanding of both. So I'm here to say thank you to Dr. Jane. I'm also here to say thank you to the Indian American community from my perspective, because some of you know that when I was in the city council, we managed to get Diwali on the alternate side of the street parking. That was a long time ago, in a decade perhaps, but it still is very meaningful to me and very meaningful that you are very supportive of my efforts.
New Jersey se hum aaye hain, JBB Center New Jersey se, aur मूल हमारा लक्ष्य वही है कि कैसे लोगों में हिंसा की भावना कम हो और अहिंसा की चेतना जगे. तो और सबसे बड़ी बात है कि आज महावीर जयंती, यहाँ महात्मा गांधी का जयंती भी मना रहे हैं. महात्मा गांधी ने रियल में भगवान महावीर को जिया, तो आज हम भी चाहते हैं कि आज सारे लोग यदि महावीर के सिद्धांतों को हम जीने लग जाएं, तो ये अहिंसा, अलग से अहिंसा दिवस मनाने की आवश्यकता नहीं रहेगी. तो रियल में हम जीने का प्रयास करें, मन से, वचन से, काया से. किसी के प्रति न बुरा सोचना है, न बुरा बोलना है और न बुरा करना है. तो रियल में ये अहिंसा का दिन और महावीर जयंती और महात्मा गांधी जयंती मनाने की सार्थकता होगी. ओम अरहम.
You are watching Vision of Asia, Voice of the Community. This program reaches you every Monday through Thursday at 8 p.m. and we have a special edition of Vision of Asia every Sunday at 11 a.m. for you. It is now time for a short break, so don't go anywhere. And now we have glimpses of a vibrant Dulhan Expo, which was held at the Renaissance Woodbridge Hotel in Iselin, New Jersey. This expo offered a wonderful opportunity for visitors to connect with wedding planners. There was a fashion show, live entertainment, and ladies had an opportunity to shop for jewelry. What made it very exciting was the presence of 73 wedding planning booths and a variety of food. Here's some highlights from that event.
Very nice event. Those who has a wedding coming up in a couple of months or days or whatever, it's really nice. Everything you get at one place, like flowers, jewelry, clothes, bridal wear. So everybody must come, and it's a really nice place to shop.
Things to try when it comes to the food and the drinks that you can have at your wedding, and also a lot of vendors for decor and makeup.
Hello everybody, Sat Sri Akal, Namaste and good afternoon. My name is Montu Singh and I'm here to attend this kind of beautiful event. Aur sab log hai, especially I would like to request all the youngsters, everything is in America, come and join this kind of time, select your stuff and enjoy.
Oh,
my name is Priya Soni, and this is my very first time modeling at the Dulhan Expo. I'm so excited. There's so many great vendors, so much amazing food. I can't wait to go up there and model.
Expo ever. We have the best crowd and best business. So please, next time, don't miss to come to this show and contact me for Jigna's Dream Collection on 732-983-8696. Thank you.
Sesame Street is a classic example of how a television show takes on social responsibility and works towards making this world a better place. Sesame Street has planned a year-long celebration to mark its 50th anniversary. The mission is to help kids everywhere grow smarter, stronger, and kinder. Sesame Street has brought the life-changing benefits of early learning to children across the globe for 50 years, and now it is reaching children in 150 countries in 70 languages. Here's a special report by ITV on the 50th anniversary of Sesame Street.
So we're all here to celebrate Sesame Street's 50th anniversary and help with the unveiling of the new Sesame Street sign.
Wow, right here.
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful news, Maria.
Yes.
What a great reason to celebrate.
You bet.
What a beautiful day. We're celebrating diversity. We're celebrating education. We're celebrating empowerment. We're celebrating kindness. How are you feeling right now and getting this proclamation by the mayor and having the name back here? What does that mean for you?
Oh, it's just a hugely exciting day. This is in honor of our 50th birthday, and it's 50 years of helping kids grow smarter, stronger, and kinder. This corner right here, this is right next to our building. This is where our headquarters is. New York is our hometown. We think we share the values. Sesame shares its values with New York. We're all about diversity and inclusion. We're about innovation. We're about leadership. And this day recognizes all of that and finally answers the question everybody asks, can you tell me how to get to Sesame Street? And now we can.
You know, your focus in the foundation is to really empower and help a lot of underprivileged community, marginalized communities, children and others. What is your take on how Sesame Street will now take forward its message? And what do you have to share about empowering those communities especially?
Well, we're in 150 countries around the world now, so we circle the globe, and some call us the longest street in the world. And that longest street in the world starts right here. And the message that we bring all around the globe is one of respect and equal access. We want everybody to have equal access to a quality education, no matter who you are, where you live, who your parents are. And we bring respect, equal opportunity, and yes, love to kids around the world.
What would you like to tell all our parents of ITV Gold on this amazing occasion of bringing Sesame Street here? What's one advice you like to give the parents?
I would like to say that 50th birthday parties can be even better than when you're 6 years old.
You know, I have to take it here now to our Cookie Monster. How are you doing?
Me terrific. Yeah.
I have such a huge request for you. A question for you is, do you only prefer cookie or do donuts also work?
Me can go for donuts. Me not gonna turn a donut down or cupcake or, you know, any kind of pastry. Me good.
Could you tell us what you can teach the kids this year or what you would like all the children to learn from you right now?
Oh, me love to teach kids about respect. It's very important to respect others. Yeah, and you know how me do that? Me share me cookies with me friends. You want the cookie?
Yes.
We're gonna go share a cookie. Me not have one on me now, but we'll get one. Yeah. And you can come too.
This year marks the 50th anniversary of when Sesame Street went on television. From the very beginning, New York City has been our hometown, as well as the physical and emotional inspiration for the street where all the Sesame Street Muppets and human characters live. So when it came to celebrating our 50th birthday, the one thing we really wanted more than any other was to finally be able to answer the often asked question, can you tell me how to get to Sesame Street? Well, now we can. It's right here at our home base in Lincoln Center. We are grateful to the city of New York for recognizing our block and letting the whole world know that Sesame Street does exist. And we are a big part of what makes New York City the great urban center that it is. I think we can all agree that New York and Sesame share important values: respect for and embracement of difference, innovation, and a willingness to lead.
This important occasion was brought to you by the number 50. 50 years of extraordinary programming, 50 years of making people's lives better, 50 years of helping children believe in themselves. It's absolutely amazing. Sesame Street changed this country. And for everyone who's been a part of it, I hope you feel that what you've done has been profoundly important. You know, we focus a lot in this city on early childhood education, but long before that, Sesame Street was helping this entire country to know how much we could achieve if we reached our kids in their earliest years. And Sesame Street did so much to help people realize those young minds, the potential of those young minds if they could be reached early. My children growing up in a multiracial family, to see the whole world presented through Sesame Street was part of their growth, was part of how they gained a sense of their place in the world. There is also something beautiful for us watching when they were young to see our own city, even our own neighborhood, portrayed in Sesame Street. And you cannot take the New York City out of Sesame Street, can you? The two go hand in hand. So Sesame Street has inspired us all. It helped us to realize what was possible. Here in this city, there's no question it helped to inspire us on our way to a city that's truly devoted to early childhood education, pre-K for all, and soon 3K for all here in New York City.
We belong miles away.
Everybody!
On my way to the air and sweet. Can you tell me how to get to Sesame Street?
63rd and Broadway.
There will be more Vision of Asia, Voice of the Community, right after these messages from our sponsors. So stay with us. A spring cocktail fundraiser was organized by the Share and Care Foundation's Professional Committee recently. This foundation is working towards gaining more accessibility and education in rural India, empower marginalized communities, and promote essential human rights of healthcare and gender equality. Community members responded to this noble call with enthusiasm. Take a look.
Thank you.
York City, and I'm your host, Aditi Lama, with cameraman Raja Bhatti. Today, we bring to you the Young Professionals Committee of the Share and Care Foundation, who are bringing together their first networking event here in New York City. The event brings together a lot of interesting professionals, young South Asians that are really passionate towards giving back to the Indian community, and also are motivated towards working in Indian nonprofits. Today, we look forward to having an entertaining time and also talking to a lot of interesting individuals, bringing to you some insights into Share and Care and why it's so important for all of us to get involved. Stay with us, I'm Aditi Lamba.
Share and Care's focus is not just give the money and get out. It's all about a holistic approach. So what we do at ARPAN is we go into the schools, we educate the children. Not only that, we go into the homes of the families, we educate the parents. Right after that, we offer self-defense classes. Not only that, we offer counseling services. We want to give a holistic approach to solving the root causes of these problems.
Shreya, you know, when talking about the charity, for all our viewers that might be just tuning in, give us a little insight into all the work that Share and Care is currently doing, you know, and especially their works towards children and women in India.
Yes. So one of the charities that I just went to India, I just got back, and one of the places I visited was ARPAN. It's an NGO that we partner with in India. It's all about sexual abuse in children and in women. So Share and Care's motto is not to just go in and treat one problem. We want to give a holistic approach and attack the root cause of the problem. So with ARPAN, what we do is we go into schools, we educate the children, we educate the parents, we do a parent seminar, then we offer self-defense classes, and then we also do follow-up counseling. So it's like a holistic approach, because these problems are so deep, like it will take time, and we need a lot of effort and support to find solutions.
You know, just talking about the support, obviously this entire event is to gain more youth support from the community. We're looking at Tri-State, which houses a lot of South Asians, young, you know, South Asian millennials. What are your hopes from this this gala? And also, you know, where exactly would you want these youth members to sort of add into Share and Care and its mission?
So I feel youth is the future. It is your ideas. It is being current with the times. What Share and Care has done is we have started a Share and Care Kids program. So that's 13 years to 18 years. Then we have our YPC, which is hosting this amazing event, which is 18, 21 plus to like 40. And then you have the general board. So we have a place for anyone to come in. Just come in, just email us that you want to be a part of this, and we will connect you with that committee. There's so many events we're doing. One of them is the upcoming 5K walk run, which is also a multi-generational event.
You know, as a key sponsor of Share and Care, and as someone who spoke so passionately about the youth to get involved, to give back, to understand the privilege we've had, could you sort of reflect a little bit more on it, and also why we should all sort of look into Share and Care?
Look, I believe in certain organizations. In life, we get exposed to lots and lots of organizations. The bottom line is this: you, Share and Care is doing grassroots level work in India. They were, I'm not gonna say they were the pioneers, but they were one of the people that you desire to work with. You're sitting here in America, you're not getting out there, and you need to go out there and reach out. And what better way to reach out than to working through organizations like Share and Care and making sure your hard-earned money is placed correctly and it goes to the right people and for the right causes. That's Share and Care. And that's why I am always going to be able to work with them, donate to them, and I feel good with them.
Share and Care Foundation, they are completely transparent. Anything you need to know about where their money and time is going is available on the website. You can call them at the office and they will tell you. And it's a testament to how many people volunteer with this organization, how great all the work that they do is just making a difference in the world.
You know, bringing together a lot of young South Asians to just sort of discuss what's happening back home in India and why charity work is so important, what sort of inspired this whole idea? And, you know, why do you think it's so important for all of us right now to sort of come together in a fun way but still discuss very important and relevant issues?
I think it's really important because these issues not only have an impact back in India, but they also have an impact here in the United States. In our generation in particular, so many of us are always looking to give back. And Share and Care Foundation is so good at making it clear about the what they're doing, who it's impacting. And you can find all that information online as well at events like this. And so getting involved, not only do you feel really great about the work you're doing, but you know that what you're doing goes back to where it should be going.
What more would you like for media to do in terms of supporting Indian nonprofits?
I think social corporate responsibility is such an important issue, and the more companies, especially media companies, that get involved, the more awareness that is brought to the issues that are affecting millions of people everywhere around the world. And when this, for example, ITV being involved with Share and Care Foundation, it helps the message go further. And I think the more press that these type of issues get, not only that, but the more companies that choose to sponsor, send representatives to these events and learn about the causes, give a part of their proceeds back to an organization, the more that people choose to get involved. Because no matter what, people are going to consume media, they're going to consume different types of products that they need in their life. And if you have to consume that type of whatever product it may be, you feel better knowing that it's all going to a good place, or at least a portion is going to a good place.
Absolutely so thrilled to be working with such brilliant young people, you know, and from so many different walks of life and who are skilled and talented in so many different ways. It's been an absolute pleasure and honor to work with everybody. And you know, you have to see our WhatsApp threads. It's like all like, yes, we're really championing each other and pushing each other to do the best that we can. And you know, that's the message that we're putting out there. We want to do the best that we can in this world and really make a difference. And so I'm really honored to be working with these fabulous people.
It is time for This Week with Padma Shri, Dr. Sudhir Parekh. Ashok Vyas spoke to him about some of the latest developments in Indian politics related to the 2019 election.
And now time for weekly show with a passionate India lover, chairman of ITV Gold and Parekh Worldwide Media. Get ready for loving sharing from physician, philanthropist, publisher, and India advocate in This Week with Padma Shri, Dr. Sudhir Parekh.
Namaskar, I'm Ashok Vyas, and welcome to this special edition of This Week with Padma Shri, Dr. Sudhir Parekh. And Dr. Sahab, I welcome you in this show. And what is it that you think when you connect yourself with news headlines from India?
For last at least 1 week, everything is hitting up too much, and there is a kind of everybody, all candidate has lost their kind of cool, and sometimes some candidates even lost their civility, and that is not good sign. In democracy, in election, civility has to be maintained. The use of the language should be proper. Then we can call it that we are mature democracy. And I think everything is heating up. Obviously, it is expected because election seems to be coming to end, and they want to win. I mean, every party wants to win as much as many seats as they can. And it's very obvious. Mm.
So, Rajab, the kind of world which you have in your mind in terms of civility, in terms of the kind of communication, dignified way of addressing each other, that seems to be non-existent at the moment. If you take it right from the campaign mounted by Congress President Chaukidar Chor hai, and there were visuals where Priyanka, Vadra, Gandhi, making kids chant this slogan.
That is wrong, mm-hmm. Absolutely wrong. And so I think fault lies with all the parties equally. So it's hard to say who
correct.
who is responsible for what. Mm-hmm. But I think hopefully kind of more wisdom and cool prevail, and after election we should all get together again to run the country under whoever wins. under leadership of either most likely Narendra Modi, but if even Narendra Modi has NDA more coalition government, so be it, as long as government performs next 5 years.
So either because indeed we love India very much, but we are not a part of that dynamic directly. So maybe we can, in a detached way, look at it coolly, calmly, and analyze right. it. Probably people who are there in the thick of the action, they are looking at it as do and die sort of situation.
Yes, of course. As I say, that it's very. It gets very when it everything hits up, and when the election comes to kind of a closed election, not one-sided election, then there's more heating up kind of, and there's more emotional, they are charged. And that's why this kind of rhetoric you can hear.
Now, let us focus few minutes on West Bengal. West Bengal Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, who is addressed as Didi by Prime Minister, she didn't respond to him when he wanted to reach out to her in order to see how the natural calamity-oriented relief work should continue. And then she ended up saying at one of her campaign rally that he's not my prime minister. How do you
I think that is unacceptable, because it doesn't matter who is your prime minister, I mean which party a prime minister belongs to, once he is holding that position, everyone should respect as a prime minister. There is no question about it.
Absolutely, and there has been a lot of words, heated words exchanged. There was another video where she objected to some people chanting Jai Shri Ram, and though from your point of view, as we have discussed in this show, we feel that elections should be above these religious divides, right. etc. But it seems as if it is very much in the center of the political discussion these days. And again, I bring to your attention this reference of Jai Shri Ram. So, should that be ignored, or should the other parties?
I mean, I'm not sure, because I don't know. We don't know the 100% of the story.
Correct.
Because yesterday I was watching one news channel, and somebody was denying it. That one of the spokesperson of the TMC was denying it, that Mamataji didn't say this way, the way you are portraying it. It is BJP's version. So we don't know. But religion, as much as possible, there are two things. Religion should be out of picture, but if you cannot, because of the emotionally charged environment, if religion comes in the picture, one should ignore it a little bit.
So where should be the focus when we look objectively and ideally? The basic issue of India's growth, development, employment, foreign policy, etc., is not being debated in a civilized fashion.
Yeah, but that is kind of unfortunate thing, because that's the way what people are interested in it at the end of the day. So whether a person is a poor or rich, they all know how they're going to the election results will going to affect his life. Whether how the economy is going to fare, how the employment will happen, interested in how their crop will be sold, and so forth, right? So very important that election has to be. But this is again is a kind of a catch 22 kind of
yes,
thing.
Yes.
So I don't think that what is happening is also it's a height of the election, emotionally charged election, where jumla is normal.
Right. And this from Jammu Kashmir and West Bengal, these are the only two states where we have heard a lot of violence having taken place near polling
yeah,
booths.
Yeah, right. So that should not happen. I mean, that's no, right.
Just staying where we are right now in terms of the race, lack of clarity as to who is going to be where and what. But comparing the position of Mamata Banerjee to Mayawati to Rahul Gandhi, to Akhilesh Yadav, when you look at all these leaders who are in the opposition and let me also bring Arvind Kejriwal here, because he also was a part of the potential Mahagathbandhan. So who appears to be strong?
I think, there is a rumor that probably if, say, opposition has a chance to form the coalition, then probably a person like Sarad Pawar will be prime minister. One who is mature, who has experience, who has been there for a long time, and that's what may end up happening.
You know, this reminds me, and again, call them jumla or statements. So recently, referring to the candidature of his daughter, Sharad Pawar said that if she loses, there'll be riots. Now, that kind of statement coming from a seasoned leader.
That is also not good.
Yeah.
That is not also good. But I think most likely BJP will win, right, either with the absolute majority of themselves, or I think they may form the coalition, which is, they have coalition partner right now. And if they need one or two more partners, I think once they win a certain number of seats, say 230 to 40 plus, then everybody will line up with them.
And also, as we are talking about Indian politics and recent happenings, I think Chief Minister of Delhi gets the credit for having been slapped in public domain maximum number of times. So recently, last week also, there was an instance of this kind. What do you make out of it in terms of your analysis? Because there are two versions.
No, well, I think again, I don't know about real incidents what happened, because I missed that one. But anyone who does any violence or any assault in public is not acceptable in democracy.
Absolutely.
Yeah, that's a real answer to it.
Yeah, so that's an ideal answer. And allow me to share briefly, since you didn't see it. So there were some visuals where one guy jumped on the jeep, which is an open jeep, and slapped him 2-3 times. And then police says that he's a disgruntled Aam Aadmi Party guy. Arvind Kejriwal says that he's a BJP guy, and he hit Arvind Kejriwal because of his statement criticizing Prime Minister regarding his relationship with Pakistan. So we don't know.
We don't know the facts. So it's hard to. But any violence is no. Whether.
So very quickly, Dr. In the election debates, both parties are revisiting history in a way. But recently, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, referring to Rajiv Gandhi, previous Prime Minister, Congress leader, as Bhrashtachari number one, it has caused different reactions from different people. Many people have felt offended. How do you see,
personally, I would not touch a person who is passed away.
Correct.
Because in Hindu culture, we do not talk anything about a person who is not here, or person even forget about being passed away, but person who is not presence, because you don't give any chance to him or her to defend him or herself. So I think it's not very wise thing, or probably a lot of people may not go well with a lot of people.
Right. So we'll see in terms.
But I'm not sure that it's significant comment anyway. It won't affect the election one way or other. So just is a non-event thing.
I agree with you. Yet what has happened is after that statement, all leaders of Congress are advocating in favor of Rajiv Gandhi, and they have reduced their rhetoric against Prime Minister Modi, Chaukidar Chore. So maybe there is some strategic thinking. I don't know about that. But as we conclude this program, at this point, your words for our viewers.
Well, I think elections are going well, and you can see that even though it's a long, 1 month long election, and still democracy is so vibrant and so versatile, that everybody is still taking part without any much really violence, or without much any untoward incidents in 1 billion people. I think we must give credit to the voters of the India, those 900 million people, those who are voting.
Absolutely.
For that dedication to democracy, and God bless India. and God bless Indian democracy, and I'm sure that it will survive many, many, many centuries to come.
Wonderful. Thank you very much, Dr. Sudeep Aisab. Thanks to all of you for being with us.
And thank you. And thank you for joining me this week. And again, we'll see you next week. Till then, goodbye. Good night. God bless America. God bless India. Jai Hind. Thank you.
It is encouraging for us at ITV Gold to hear positive feedback from our viewers about the program content. Thanks for becoming friends of ITV Gold page on Facebook. Continue sending us details about events to us at events@itvgold.com and do subscribe to ITV Gold's YouTube channel. That is all the time we have for this week's Vision of Asia, Voice of the Community. Thanks for making us a part of your weekend. Do join us next week at the same time right here on ITV Gold. Until then, have a great week ahead. I'm Kala Shankar. Namaste.